So your doctor told you you have blepharitis. What does this mean and are you gonna be okay? Honestly, blepharitis is one of the most common conditions I see in patients of all ages. Let me tell you what it is and what we can do to treat it. All right, so blepharitis is an inflammation of the eyelids. There's two ways that you categorize it, anterior and posterior. Essentially what this means in layman's terms is anterior is your eyelashes, posterior is the actual eyelid margin. Usually I see a combination of both. So let's start with anterior blepharitis or your eyelashes. Your eyelashes are meant to be a defense mechanism for your eye. It stops debris, dust, wind, everything from the environment from getting into your eye. Well, over time, that debris and all the dust and bacteria will accumulate on the lids and lashes, especially those eyelashes, if you're not cleaning them properly. This can cause a loss of lashes or even eye infections. Leave a comment below if this has ever happened to you. Okay, let's talk about posterior blepharitis. This is actually the eyelid margin. The eyelid margin has glands in it that secrete part of the tear film. This secretion should be an oil that comes out of your eyelid, but when they get plugged up, the lid becomes inflamed, it turns into more of a solid. A solid does not express or spread well. This causes an unstable tear film. The unstable tear film is what causes blurry, dry eyes. Now, the lid itself, when they're plugged, can get infected. This is what a sty is. If the infection of that gland spreads to the other glands, the entire eyelid is affected. This can be very problematic because the thing that rests behind your eyes is your brain. We do not want that eyelid infection to go to the back of your eye or your brain. So clean eyelids can keep your brain healthy as well. Now remember, excess screen time or staring is another way that those glands get plugged up. These are things that we're trying to prevent. Okay, now that we know what's happening, let's talk about how to treat it. The first line of defense is lid hygiene. Lid scrubs or a hypochlorous acid spray are my go-tos. Essentially, this is gonna get all that bacteria, all that debris off your lids and lashes. This will help keep the glands from getting inflamed and keep your lashes healthy, long, and looking great. So when you think of lid hygiene, think of brushing and flossing. This is something that has to be done on a daily basis. If you stop brushing your teeth, they're gonna get gunky and you're gonna have bad breath. If you stop cleaning your eyelashes, they're gonna get gunky and you're gonna get lid infections. So brush your lashes. Now, if you've heard me talk about this before, drop a like below. So lid hygiene is our go-to, it's a staple of how we treat blepharitis. But sometimes the infection's too much for lid hygiene to handle by itself, or you have a demodex blepharitis. This is a parasite that actually lives in those lashes. The way to treat this is with medication. We have Xdemvy for demodex, and then we have antibiotics for eyelid infections. Whatever we do, we still have to do the lid hygiene, but sometimes you need some bigger guns to knock out the bacteria. In addition to lid hygiene, warm compresses are my go-to. This will keep those glands open and expressing. Doing this with lid hygiene is your best defense from getting eye infections or getting a buildup of bacteria on those lids and lashes that's gonna cause irritation, redness, and itching. The last thing you need to think about is supplementation and diet. If you can have a diet rich in omega-3 fatty acids or supplement omega-3 fatty acids that are high in EPA and DHA, about 2,000 to 3,000 milligrams, this is gonna help your body produce better oils and reduce inflammation. So all in all, blepharitis may sound scary, but there's a ton that we can do to keep your eyes happy and healthy. Hit that subscribe button and we'll see you in the next video.